I just want to follow up on burnout and why it didn't work very well in the EFA. But in order to understand why the burnout items don't factor very well, we need to review formative versus reflective measurement. Now, perhaps the simplest way to know if something is formative or reflective is to consider whether the underlying items are interchangeable. If they're interchangeable, then the measures are reflective. If not, then they're formative. It's really that easy. So here's that slide from last time. Are the diet items interchangeable? Do they essentially mean the same thing? Ask yourself, if I answer strongly agree to one, will I answer strongly agree to the others? In this case, if I have a balanced diet, I probably also don't eat much junk food, and I probably eat healthy food. It would be a contradiction otherwise. So these are all asking the same thing. Whereas for health, I can have a balanced diet, but not exercise regularly or sleep enough. These are three very different items. Certainly, all of them are related to health, but they are not interchangeable. Interchangeability implies correlation. The EFA is a tool for finding groups of highly correlated items. So this works great for interchangeable, reflective measures. However, formative measures are not required to be correlated. This means the EFA does not always work on formative measures. If we look at the survey for the Suhana dataset, we can see that each burnout construct is actually comprised of three separate dimensions: emotional exhaustion, reduced personal accomplishment, and depersonalization. These are not interchangeable dimensions. Therefore, burnout is a formative construct, right? Well, yes, but that's not the whole story. More precisely, burnout is a second-order formative construct with three first-order reflective dimensions, each measured by two interchangeable observed items. Yeah. Soak it up. Cool, huh? And that's why we see the pattern matrix like this. Each dimension essentially gets its own factor. Except factor one. What's the deal with that? It gets two dimensions. Well, it just so happens that these four items are highly correlated. And that's why they factor together. Well, I hope this has been more informative than confusing. And I'll see you next time.